some deliberation over how postmodernism relates to film. Some believe it's a time frame, as in anything created after the modernist phase of film, while others believe that it's a specific style. However, to understand postmodernism, firstly we have to understand what modernism was. Modernism was interested in grand and meta-narratives of history and nature. The theory suggested that everything happens for intrinsic purposes, which all add up to one overall meaning of life. The theory came about after World War I, when society saw the development of modern industry and rapid growth of cities. The rich grew richer and the poor grew poorer. Hierarchies rose higher and society was taught to conform to consumerism, the nuclear family, and the idea of working hard to achieve success. Postmodernism undermines all of this theory. Instead, the movement is interested in contradiction, fragmentation, and instability. Often it suggests that any derived meaning from signification is simply lies. Like I mentioned earlier, some believe postmodernism to be a specific style of filmmaking. We often relate it to comedic, camp, and ironic films. Nonetheless, this isn't always true.
I love the Smiths.
Sorry?
I said I love the Smiths. You've criticized the music.
You like the Smiths?
Due to its non-linear narrative style and its celebration of popular music, 500 Days of Summer also fits into a postmodernist category. In the expectations versus reality scene, the film shows the truth behind relationships, hereby calling out all the unrealistic ideals created by romantic films today. Individuals may create postmodern film through the use of intertextuality, self-referentiality, and parody. Intertextuality is a reference to other texts within a film. The Scary Movie franchise is a parody of horror films, which is almost entirely made up of intertextuality.
Do you like scary movies?
Mm-hmm.
What's your favorite?
Another way intertextuality is used in film is by taking the storyline from a classic novel or play and turning it into a more modern film. This is used in many rom-coms, for example, Clueless takes Jane Austen's Emma, and 10 Things I Hate About You takes Shakespeare's Taming of the Shrew. Self-referentiality is when a film challenges the audience's suspension of disbelief. This can be done by breaking the fourth wall, like in Ferris Bueller's Day Off, by mocking the conventions of film, like in Wayne's World,
I will not bow to anybody.
Or through acknowledging that the film is fictional entirely, like in Blazing Saddles, when the action breaks through to the next door studio.
Hey boys! Look what I got here! Hey, where are the white women at?
Blazing Saddles is also an extremely brilliant example of a parody, which is the third strand of postmodern technique in film. Parody films take the conventions of gender, race, class, genre, and time and flip them on the head to form hilarious outcomes.
Steady as a rock.
Yeah, but I shoot with this hand.
Shaun of the Dead parodies human ignorance and also the zombie apocalypse genre.
She's so drunk.
Young Frankenstein parodies Mary Shelley's classic novel.
Life's alive!
And Monty Python parodies, well, everything. From history to religion to politics to the grand narrative itself. Helping us remember that postmodernism isn't just for the cynical.
Always look on the bright side of life.
Thanks for watching.
Always look on the light side of life.